Hey guys, it's me, Lucky Ghost. And before you ask, yes, I'm still stranded on this deserted island. But that's not going to stop me from telling you about the next event. Coming up next is the Tribunal Celebration. This event runs from February 25th at 10 a.m. Eastern until Tuesday, March 9th at 10 a.m. Eastern. During this event, you can receive the following bonus rewards when adventuring in Vardenfell and Clockwork City zones. One of the easiest ways to participate in this event will be to do the zone daily quests in both Clockwork City and Vardenfell. During this event, you will earn two reward boxes rather than one. And for you node harvesters out there, you will earn increased rewards for harvest nodes during this event in these two zones, not including fishing holes and heavy sacks. So if you happen to have a collection of surveys sitting in your bank for Vardenfell and Clockwork City, now is the time to do them, because you will be earning double the loot for each one during this event. In addition to that, world bosses, delve bosses, and trial bosses in Clockwork City and Vardenfell will drop additional loot when defeated. Public dungeon bosses and world bosses have a chance to drop tradable new style pages for the new Doctrine Ordinator outfit. There are two public dungeons in Vardenfell. Up here in the north, you have the Forgotten Wastes, and down here in the south, you have Chinlufin Gethvin. And down here in the south, you have Enchulefting. The public dungeon bosses and world bosses have a chance to drop tradable new style pages for the Doctrine Ordinator outfit style. The final boss in both Asylum Sanctorum and Halls of Fabrication have a guaranteed chance to drop a tradable style page for the new Doctrine Ordinator outfit style. So queue up those normal Asylum Sanctorum plus 2 fights and earn a ton of these style pages. In addition to these bonus rewards, when you complete a daily quest in either one of the two zones, you'll receive a Tribunal coffer. Each of these coffers have a chance to receive some of these items: crafted materials, overland set items from the two zones, style pages, and in rare cases, entire motif chapters for the Ashlander, Moragtong, Telvanni, Radoran, Lalu, Ebon Shadow, and Clockwork Apostle styles. In addition to this, they may also include Transmute Crystals and Vardenfell or Clockwork City treasure maps. In addition to these items, we have three new items added this year. The Slagtown Diver Skin Rune Box, which will earn you an entire skin if you're lucky enough to find the Rune Box. The Thetis Ramirez's Bait Kit Memento Rune Box. And if you're looking for a new pet, you can earn fragments for the Microtized Verminous Fabricant Pet. Because of the double coffers, it will very much be worth doing your dailies on multiple tunes every day in these zones. But at the very least, make sure to do at least one daily in each zone, because that's how you're going to earn your tickets. And the first time you complete a daily each day, you will receive a Glorious Tribunal coffer. A Glorious Tribunal coffer contains the same items as the regular counterparts, but have a higher chance at receiving some of the rarer items, such as the skin, the memento, and the pet fragments. During this event, regular Tribunal coffers also have a chance to drop randomly from various zone activities, including defeating bosses, looting objects, and even slaying random monsters. Now, in order to participate in this event, you will need to have access to Morrowind and Clockwork City, which means you will need to either have ESO Plus or you will need to purchase these DLCs separately. If you're in the latter group, don't worry. Both of these DLCs will be 50% off through the duration of the event, which means they will be on sale for 50% off from February 25th through March 9th. Now let's talk about the Impresario and the event tickets. Throughout the event, you can earn 2 tickets per day. The first event will come from doing a daily in Vardenfell. The second event ticket will come from your first Clockwork City daily. It's worth noting that the event ticket timer resets at 1 a.m. Eastern each morning. And remember, there is a 12 ticket limit that you can hold. Any tickets you earn beyond 12 will disappear into the void, so be sure to spend those tickets before you get to 12. In order to check how many tickets you have, be sure to click on your currency tab in your inventory and then just look for event tickets to see how many you have. So, what will the Impresario be selling this event? Well, I'm glad you asked. The unstable Morpholith base fragments will be for sale again in case you were unable to complete your pet last event or in case you want to start building a second one. In addition to that, the second piece of the Deadlands Scorcher skin fragment will be available during this event. The first piece that we were able to buy during the last event will also be for sale again during this event in case you missed it last time. Which means after this event is over, you will have the first two pieces of the skin, with the rest to come in the following events. Beyond that, you'll be able to buy the Doctrine Ordinator outfit style pages, the Slagtown Diver skin, Thetis Ramirez's bait kit memento, the Microtized Verminous Fabricant pet, and group repair kits. And remember, anything that you buy with event tickets is account bound, so be sure that you don't buy anything from the impresario with the intent of selling it, because you won't be able to do so. Okay, now I'm going to show you where these daily quests are and what they have you do, just so that you know where to go. There are a total of 4 daily quests in Morrowind. There's a couple things you have to do to unlock them before they will appear. In order to get the 2 dailies that are down here in Vivec, you're going to first need to do the first piece of the Zone Story quest. In order to do that, click here, click open zone guide, and then start the zone story. After you do the first part and you talk to Vivec, you'll be able to come over here and talk to a wanted poster. After you interact with this wanted poster and complete the quest, you will then be able to head into this area right here, the Halls of Justice, and once inside, you'll be able to interact with the 2 NPCs that are going to be able to give you the daily quests. And once you get inside, you'll immediately see the daily quest markers on your compass and perhaps even in game here. And you'll have this one here, and it shows us that delve is right here, although the delve quest that you pick up may ask you to go to any one of the delves in the zone. For this one, it's saying go right here. To check which delve quests you have, just simply open the journal and then press M, and it's going to show you the location of the delve quest. If you're in here and you press it, it might bring you to this map. Just right click once, zoom out, and then boom, there you go. It's going to show you where the delve is. Okay, next one is going to be this daily here, which is going to be a world boss daily. So if we pick this up, we press J, then we press M, it's going to take us to this world boss down here. And again, as with the delve quest, it may ask you to kill any world boss in the zone. All you have to do is run out, take care of those 2 quests, come back, turn in your rewards to get your double boxes and all of your goodies. In order to unlock the other 2 quests, you're going to need to go to Alduin, located right here, and complete the quest called Ashlander Ties. After completing that quest, head to the Urisha Laku camp up here in the northwest and talk to an NPC named Udami, who's going to have you do a turn-in quest that takes you right back down to Alduin. Once you've turned that quest in down here, the 2 daily NPC quest givers will appear, and you'll be able to do those dailies every day as well. Right when you get to Clockwork City, 2 daily quests will be available to you. In order to unlock the Delve daily quests, you'll first need to complete the Delve quests themselves. So head to the Delves, complete their quests, and then come back, and you'll be able to pick up the dailies. So the daily NPCs will be standing right here where we're at right now. Here's the shrine. You've got 2 dailies right here, and then you've got the next 2 just north of the shrine here, giving you a total of 4 daily quests to do in Clockwork City every day, for a total of 8 quests that you can do every day when you combine Vardenfell and Clockwork City. Now don't worry, you only need to do 1 daily in each zone to get your tickets. You don't have to do all 8 if you don't want to, and only the first quest gives you the daily Glorious Bot. So only do as many dailies as you find fun. Don't feel stressed about having to do all 8 every single day. Unless you enjoy it, then hey, all the better. Once you've completed your dailies, you'll be able to interact with the Impresario. And to find an Impresario, simply head to Daggerfall inside of Glenumbra. And right here on the other side of this bridge, the Impresario will appear during every single event. So you can either go to this Way Shrine and head over here if you've got this one, the Bellborn Rock Way Shrine. Otherwise, just hop over to the Daggerfall Way Shrine and jog on over across the bridge, and you'll see the Impresario standing there. Interact with them, and you can browse their wares. And that is everything you need to know to make the most of the Tribunal event. What do you plan to buy with your tickets? Are you going to go for the skin, the pet, the style pages, or all of the above? Let me know in the comments down below. As always, be sure to like and subscribe if you enjoy this content and would like more ESO content. And if you ever want to hang out with someone else who loves ESO, be sure to swing by my Twitch stream at twitch.tv/luckyghosttv. Link will be in the description below. Until the next video, guys, have a fantastic day, night, or evening, wherever you might be. I'll see you next time.